and we're going to be getting live with Snatcha. He's live in London. He's got a brand new single, which we're going to be playing. First of all, though, we want to get him on air and have a little chat with him, because Snatcha's never been on HopeJamz before, so we'll have a little chat with him. Snatcha, you there, man?
Yeah, it was good, man. It was good, good. Man, thank you for having me.
Yeah, man, welcome.
What's happening?
Yeah, man, welcome to HopeJamz, man. It's been a while, man. Yeah, I wanted to get you on for
it's
a while.
First time, so yeah, man. I'm excited.
Yeah, man. So, we obviously want to get into the single in a bit, but this is the first time you've been on the show, so I wanted to kind of get the download of who you are to the audience. So, if you will, man, give yourself an introduction, like how you got into the music scene, if testimonies wrapped up in there as well, just put it all in together. Yeah.
My name is Snatcha, and I think this year makes it 18 years since I got into, started doing hip hop music, and I think I was born with it. My dad was working the radio, so I think obviously I had to gravitate to that. And I started university, started with my friend. We started a group called G-Force. 18 years ago, we were called G-Force, that's Gospel Force. We were six, and a few years down the line, we became two. Had a single back then called Shock Therapy, and it was a blend of rock, rap, and a style of Nigerian street music called Fuji. It was really crazy. It was different, and that shot us to the limelight, sort of. A lot of people were like, "Oh my God, how dare they mix these forms of music together and all that stuff?" And later on, we did another track called Lagimo, which literally means God hit me on the head with a stick, and that's us just using that as a metaphor to say, you know, when pride gets into your head, when you begin to follow your agenda instead of God's agenda, that God should take everything that you hold dear, strip it all away, and just, you know, just give me God. And so we did that for about for a while, you know, 18 years in the music industry, until, you know, eventually after our third album as Rooftop MCs, God just started speaking to us in a different direction. And it was my partner that said he was hearing God say, you know what, we actually need to shut it down. You know, sometimes when the fame now becomes, fame is an addictive drug, when it becomes like, you know, it starts getting to your head, and you're preparing more for the limelight, the flashing lights of the ministry, than doing the ministry in itself. You know, and I believe that God is more concerned about his servants than the message he's sending the servants to deliver. So, you know, God just basically took us apart and said, you know, I need to deal with you individually. So I moved to the UK, got my family, and started my solo, didn't do music for a while. And so God started speaking to me, okay, it's time to do this and time to do that. So I released my first solo album called The Valley of Nothing. That was about three years ago. And now I'm currently working on a new set of songs for a new album called 1.5 Miles to Canaan. So that's kind of like me in a nutshell.
Nice one. So yeah, man, yeah. You've been a busy man then. You've been in and out of the scene.
Yeah.
And is it right in saying, like, were you in Africa at one point as well?
Yeah, I started off in Nigeria.
Nice, man. So how's the kind of the difference in the scene over here to there? Is it like a massive difference? Do you even have a scene in Nigeria?
I think Nigeria is a lot different, because I believe there are a lot more opportunities in Nigeria. I believe the atmosphere is a lot more receptive. I mean, there's a tougher ground to fight in Nigeria, because what we did was we're one of the first to be able to break in the mainstream, and we were emphasizing the fact that there's really no need to separate mainstream hip-hop from gospel hip-hop. That was my term. That was what I was emphasizing back in the day, because I believe that good music is good music, and if our music is supposed to be evangelical, you know, well, let's just do it and make sure it's perfect. So when you put it side by side with everything the quote-unquote mainstream is doing, they cannot help but deny that, yes, this has content, this is dope, and there's something different, which we call the spirit, that's in the music that will touch every ear and heart that listens to it and bring them closer to God. Do you get me?
Yeah, man, I get what you're saying. That's a good idea, man. I think that's rock solid right there.
Yeah, but we had a lot of people misunderstanding, thinking, oh, they're denying Christ. No, we're not denying Christ. We were at that point denying, because we had an album called the Minority Report. And what we're trying to emphasize on the album is that, you know, we're trying to use the analogy of the spies that Abraham, that Moses sent out to spy out the land, and to the minority, the two came back to say, oh, we can take that land. You know, so we're saying that, look, we can take mainstream without changing our message, without removing, substituting Jesus for him and God for he, and, you know, just saying God, Jesus, declaring his word and still being dope. That was our emphasis at that point.
Yeah, man, I understand that completely, man. I think you're always going to get some kind of pressure if you're like,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you do certain things, and certain people, there's always going to be someone who says, like, well, are you doing the right thing, kind of thing, you know? Anyway, man. Yeah, tell us about the new music then, man, because you've been recently putting out, obviously, stuff in time for this new album that you want to put out. So tell us about the album, man.
Yeah, what I'm trying to do with it is, because I took my music off Spotify. I took my music off Spotify and because I wanted to head on a new direction with my music, because I wanted my music to be, God has taken me a new direction, basically, to make my music free or pay what you want. So I wanted people, even with, when I go out to minister and they say, oh, so how much is your fee? I'm like, no, I don't charge. It's what the Lord says. So whatever the Lord puts in your heart, just, you know, or give. So I just go for a free will donation. So I took my music off Spotify, I took my music off iTunes and the rest of them. And the other reason is because I want to have a relationship or know who exactly is listening and downloading my music. So I put my music on somewhere called Gumroad, where if you download, I get your email. So I can first of all send you an email to say, oh, thank you so much for downloading my music. And what do you think? Is it blessing you? Do you have anything you want me to pray about? You know, basically create a community. So the album is called 1.5 Miles to Canaan. Basically, it's just to say that I'm not there yet. I'm not, you know, I can feel it. I can feel the presence. I'm rejoicing and celebrating like I already have the promise, even though I know that I've already received the promise, he said. Yeah. So I'm just doing a collection of songs that are just fun, exciting, and just giving God all the praise.
Nice one. Okay, so when can we expect that? When's the album coming?
Most of the songs are done. Every single thing is recorded in my house. All the producers are from Nigeria. They just send it to me. Because I've been spending so much time at home lately. So I just record everything at home, send it to be mixed and mastered. So, and for now, I've released three singles. And by March, the entire album will be done. And so by March, it should be out in March.
Nice one. All right, well, look forward to that, definitely, man. I've been dropping all your singles, and I've been liking each and every one of them, and they were really live, you know. The mixture, I know what you said at the beginning, the mixture, like how you said at the beginning, like how did people kind of react to it, and I think that it's good, man. I like the mixture that you have. It's kind of like dance or hip-hop.
Yeah, because it's different, because most people know that I grew up from the school of hip-hop, that I mean the steady beat, the boom bap, and you know, so, but I'm more experimental with my hip-hop, so I could take a bit of jazz here, I could take a bit of soul here, take a bit of stuff and Afrobeat and mixed it all together. It's still hip-hop, but I'm more concerned about the spirit behind the song and the message.